I'm Erin Silva. I'm an organic production scientist in the Department of Agronomy at UW-Madison. Today we're out in an organic no-till field, and this field is going to be planted with the organic no-till technique using the roller crimper. Here you see the standing rye. This rye was planted in the fall, around mid-September, at a rate of about 4 bushel per acre. We let this rye come through the winter. Last winter was in 2012-2013. Was a little bit hard on the crop with the freeze-thaw events, but typically the rye comes through very well. The rye was a little bit delayed this year as well with the cooler spring. So now it's early part of June before we're able to get out to the field to terminate the rye. But we are looking for a very specific stage of the rye before we go through with the roller and crimper for termination. What we're looking for is for the anthers to be coming off of the rye head, so the rye is now at anthesis. By waiting till this stage, we ensure that the rye will be effectively terminated and won't remain growing and competing with our cash crop in this field, which will be soybean. The roller crimper, designed by the Rodale Institute, is a large cylindrical piece of equipment that is mounted on the rear part of a tractor with a triple hitch. It goes and rolls the rye crop perpendicular to the direction of planting. So we lay the rye crop down and it creates a nice thick mat on the soil surface. The roller crimper terminates the rye through two different modes of action. It rolls the rye down, but it also, through its chevron blades, actually crimps the rye stalks. And through that crimping action, will ensure that that rye stays down on the ground and create a dead straw mat throughout the production season. Here at UW, what we do is we come through and roll the rye with the roller crimper and then follow that with a no-till planter. We either use a no-till corn planter and plant on 30-inch rows or a no-till grain drill. Either one of those has worked fine. A key aspect though is to just set that drill at a little bit deeper depth to ensure that the seed is able to penetrate through the mat and get into the ground. We plant the soybean at a rate of 200,000 seeds per acre, and that soybean will come right through that mulch and grow and produce a nice crop. Generally, we've been getting about 40 to 50 bushel an acre off of that soybean crop. To get any more information off this technique, you can contact me, visit my website at uworganic.wisc.edu, or contact your local county extension agent.